morning. Today I am here to explain how to determine the hardness of ferrous and non-ferrous materials using Brinell's hardness testing machine. This is the Brinell hardness testing machine. It consists of a lever arm and indicator which transmits the load to the test piece. It varies in size and shape for different testers. It is having here we are using a steel ball of 10 mm diameter. They are made up of like hardened steel or diamond. Now we are having the materials here, like the apertures, brass and micrometer, microscope and a stopwatch. Here we are having two types of materials. One is ferrous and the other one is non-ferrous. Brass and steel. Brass can have a load capacity of 1000 kilogram force and steel can have load capacity of 3000 kilogram force. Here we are using a brass specimen. Now take the specimen and keep it on the sitting platform. Make sure that it is at the middle or somewhere where there is no indentation. And then lock the release valve with the help of lever arm. By turning it clockwise. Now with the help of lever arm, bring the indentator down so that it just touches the surface of our specimen. Make sure that the indentator just touches the surface of the specimen, and now we can see that we have a small error of somewhat 100. So while taking the readings, we have to add 100 along with the 1000 kilogram force, and now we can apply a load of 1000 kilogram force. Since we have an error of 100 kilogram force, so add that also. Okay, and now take a stopwatch and apply for a load of 1000 kilogram force for 15 seconds and wait for 15 seconds. Now it's 15 seconds, so release the lock by the release valve and turn it anti-clockwise. Now it is getting released. Now we can see that there is a small indentation on this specimen. Now take a chalk and fill that with the chalk powder so that we can see it clearly, diameter. Now take a micrometer, microscope, put it above it and see the diameter. Now the diameter is found to be 3 mm diameter. Now we can do the calculation part. We are applying the load from here and there is a depth of indentation, that is from here till over here, which is small h. So here we have small h is equal to depth of indentation, which is in mm, which is equal to d minus root over d square minus small d square divided by 2. Here d is the diameter of steel ball, which is in mm, and small d is the mean diameter of indentation, which is also in mm. And now we have the
Brinell's hardness number is equal to test load divided by surface area, which is equal to P divided by pi D into H, which is equal to 2P by pi D into D minus root over D square minus small d square. Okay, this is the Brinell's hardness number. Since we got a value of 350.41, which is a decimal, we have to round it into whole number. Suppose 350 HBS, which is the hardness Brinell steel, 10 divided by 1000, which is explained as Brinell hardness of 350 is determined by a steel ball of 10 mm diameter for a load of 1000 kilogram force applied for 15 seconds. So here we got the value.
Thank you.